I'm with Brian and Jamie Johnson from Frankfort, South Dakota, and we're just here to talk about your lands and what you have here. We've spent a little bit of time in the field looking at some of the things that they've been doing, and it's been pretty impressive. I'd like you to tell us a little bit about what your system looks like and how you're integrating everything in to that system.
Well, in several decades ago, there used to be a lot of small grain in this part of the state and in this county. And then as time went along, wheat wasn't as profitable, and this became more of a corn and soybean area. I think kind of continues with the theme that the Corn Belt moved west in a way. So we can produce some great corn and soybean around here, but then you don't have the diversity in your crop rotation that I think we're seeing the benefits of now. And so we've been trying to bring back as much wheat as possible on the fields that require that more diversity in our operation. And so instead of just corn and beans, we've got some spring wheat, corn and bean rotation. We grow some oats and occasionally some barley. You know, it just depends on what our feed needs are for our livestock as well. And so by using the small grain, we're able to really shine with our cover crop behind that rotation. And because it can grow for 2+ months in the fall after spring wheat harvest, and okay. So it's another avenue to add some diversity in our soil for our crops. And it's now that we've also incorporated our livestock back into certain fields that are near the farm during in the winter season, it's a little bit more diversity there as well. The economics of farming have to work, and that's where, you know, you still have to be able to pencil a profit. We've found that we can produce the yields for our wheat that can make it profitable, and then by following with a cover crop, our corn and our soybeans are more profitable the next year.